The biggest step of this decade is scaling up the development of a global clean energy economy. Energy accounts for 3/4 of global greenhouse gas emissions, how we power our homes, how we power our cars, and so forth. And by 2030, we have to speed up the deployment of the clean technologies that we already have, put them on super steroids, and deploy. According to the International Energy Agency, that means the equivalent of building the world's biggest solar plant every day for the next decade, ramping up renewable energy from wind and solar by 4 times what it is today to reach 1,000 gigawatts installed per year in 2030. It means ensuring that in 2030, 60% of new car sales around the world are electric vehicles. And all of this will fuel clean energy investment boom globally, reaching $4 trillion a year by 2030. That is the task ahead of us. Second, we must also need to develop and demonstrate and scale up emerging technologies during this decade so that they can play a major role in decarbonizing the global economy by 2050. Between now and 2030, the IEA says that governments are going to need to invest $90 billion in technology demonstration projects. We'll need to rapidly scale up green hydrogen and clean fuels that can slash emissions from heavy industries, cement, concrete, aluminum, steel. We'll also need to develop the equivalent of installing the largest carbon capture storage facility currently in operation. But we have to do that every 9 days through 2030. A raft of other technologies spanning advanced renewables and nuclear, long-duration energy storage, smart grids, battery storage, direct air carbon capture. So many different things that could provide the saving grace, but they all need to be commercialized and scaled. And this is even more of a challenge. And third, if we invest heavily in clean energy and in energy efficiency that curbs rising global demand for energy, and then, of course, fossil fuels, the demand will naturally drop. Starting now, the IEA tells us that we do not actually need a new investment in oil, coal, or gas production because they're simply not necessary to meet our energy needs given other technologies that are online and coming online. By 2040, we should have entirely phased out all unabated coal and unabated oil plants and sharply reduced reliance on unabated natural gas generation. And the good news, my friends, is that the proof is all around us that we can do this. Clean energy technologies are already cheaper than fossil fuels, and we have a playbook to do the same thing across many other emerging clean technologies.